my 10th year anniversary of my survival after someone left me for dead in the living room of my apartment on 15th Street. I think they really believe I was gone. I truly believe they thought they had destructed me. I sincerely think that they thought I was done. But I woke up. I woke up. You know, since I was 16, my life has not been easy. I have seen what death looks like. I smell what pain smells like. In all of the years that I was able to make it, I knew there was a reason behind it. I'm not here by coincidence. I've always knew there was a purpose for me to still be standing. I'm about to be 50 years old. So I know the purpose is there. Thank you. But I have to recognize that it has not been easy. Because it's a struggle. Life is a struggle. But it's also a beautiful thing. Through it all, I thank the higher power that I never did one thing. I've done it all. I've done many things. One thing I did not do. And that was to give up. Time and time again, no matter how deep the punches, how hard the words felt, how it really hurts, I never gave up. I was always one of those that people will really throw me, but I will always bounce. So, standing here in front of you on a Saturday night, I know that there was one thing that kept me alive. And that is the one thing I hope that I am able to share with all of you. And it's called love. It's called love. I have great love for myself. I love all of this. I adore, I am in love with myself. Because I am my own special creation. I am. There's been many labels put on me. Tranny. Prostitute, AIDS carrier, homeless bitch, ugly, indigenous, you name it. But I always knew that I was different. I'm not like everybody else. There's no two people like me. If you find her, let me know. You need to talk, honey. I really think there's only one. Please let me know. But I tell you, because no matter what came my way, I always had love. I had love for myself, and then I have plenty, and I really do, that I could share it with someone else. So, I am also a great believer that collective power, collective work, does change outcomes. It does. I was destined to be another statistic, trans woman of color, dead by 33. but I'm part of a beautiful family. I'm part of a beautiful community called the LGBT community. So no matter what happened, there was always someone there by my side, and many of them when I was growing up, that I felt that I needed to do something. And I wanted a space that was full of love. And I'm gonna tell you something, if you don't know it, but I hope you felt it. Love lives in this house. This is not a shelter. Baby, this is not a shelter. You see how grand it is? They ain't got a microphone that don't work. The problem is, are you hearing me? Love lives in this house. So if you're like me, that sometimes didn't feel the love, let me tell you, you need to be here. Because love lives in this house. Anytime you walk through that door, which I'm going to have that glass workplace, you're in the house of love. Love lives in this house. I have plenty of love to give that I wanted it to live here. So I'm going to share this song that I think it was, they wrote it for a different reason, because I think it is kind of sad when I saw the video. But if you really listen to what the song says, it speaks a lot of what I have for you. But more importantly, is what keeps me alive today. It's what keeps me alive. So I need you to sing along with me, because this is what I want you to remember before you go to bed today. Before you close your beautiful eyes, before you actually, you know, go on to the next dimension, I want you to think about this word, love. So I'm going to tell you that I love you, and I need you to tell me that you love me. So let's get started. Yeah.
Warm round of applause for Ms. Ruby, everybody.
Sell it, girl, sell it.
Take your ownership to better for yours.
That's the show. That's a long version. I'm going to cut it to when it starts singing. Can you try it? Because I think that's the long version.
That's the long version.
Yeah, I needed the short one.
And that's kind of cracking on.
Are you loving my dress?
Love it.
I am loving this dress.
Nice to see you.
It's a rainbow.
Hi, girl. I'm just hanging out at the house, chilling.
I'm not chilling.
Okay.
I'm at storytelling.
Yes.
Yes.
It's very cool.
Okay, here we go.
He's one of my best friends.
That's fucking
a little nice.
Are you jealous?
I don't have to be jealous of
that's the drama. You know, that's always something drama. No, all the time.
Me in the fucking restaurant, in the car, on the walk, on the way to her own fucking.
That's the drama we come through every day.
On the walk, on the way to her own fucking house.
Every day there's always something, right?
That's right.
Always. Yeah. Something didn't work, something went wrong. But trust me. Here we go. Loud.
Oh no, here we go again, fighting over what I said. I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm sorry. Better love, no, I'm not good at this, but I can say I'm innocent. I'm hardly.
Yo,
but I'm sorry.
Who's free to go?
Where are you?